Hello everyone. So for the past year, we've been struggling with some pests. They seem to attack only our thin-leaved orchids, and we tried to keep it in check with some insecticide spray. But recently, we moved our oncidiums to another room, and whatever pests we've been having seem to have taken off. Even our African violets are showing damage.
So we thought of pulling out the old microscope and figuring out once and for all what pest we have exactly, and if the spray is doing anything. The plant most affected seems to be what's left of our zygopetalum, so let's look at that first.
As you can see, the leaves are all pitted and show a lot of damage. But for now, we see no bugs. This plant has been sprayed with insecticide countless times, so they might be gone on this one. We saw some red dots. And some white, bug-like things in the crevices, but no movement. The red dots could be spider mites, but at least these I don't think are alive anymore.
Next, we looked for pests on this poor plant that has previously been sunburned and now is clearly being munched on. This is what those round marks look like under the microscope. This other leaf has even more marks. The leaves are clearly very damaged under the microscope, but still, we were expecting to see movement.
The next plant, however, we hit the jackpot. And it's official now, we have spider mites. Wasn't expecting to find so many though. The hardest part was being able to follow them. They are fast when they get on the move. On this one, we can tell that the white specks we found on the previous plants are clearly either spider mite molds or long dead ones.
We checked some other oncidiums, but none other than this one is affected anymore. And that makes sense. The yellow twinkle was the last one in flower, so it stayed in the orchid room and didn't get the insecticide like the others. We will be fixing that right now. This insecticide is based on abamectin, and it should work on spider mites, as it kills them by ingestion. As you can see, a few days later, we find nothing but dead mites.
We also checked the African violet propagations we had with damaged leaves. But it doesn't seem to be spider mites after all. But the leaves are still really beautiful under the microscope. We're thinking of making a separate video, just filming plant parts under the microscope. We think it'll be interesting.
So that was a mystery easy to solve. We were pretty sure it was just spider mites. But since the problem keeps coming back, we wanted to make sure. And we also thought it would make a fun video. If they come back again after this, though, I'll probably give the good old soap and oil solution a try.
Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other tips on dealing with spider mites, please let us know in the comments. And don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to our channel.
We'll see you next week. Goodbye.